And yet another day on the Dyane, and hopefully this will be the last day for this one. I hope that we will get the engine running and have it out for a test run today. That's my hope and dreams, because I have another project that I'm looking forward to get started on, which is a... I know, it's not a car. And also, this box has arrived, which indicates that we can get cracking on the Renault 5 GT Turbo build again. Those should be the engine parts. But this will have to be finished first. All this will have to be cleaned before we can go on. So, yesterday we put the engine back in. I've already started by putting the nuts on and tightening the engine together with the two halves. The one down there is quite difficult to get at. I can only advise to do it from underneath, especially if you have a lift. So I've just changed the oil filter and drained the old oil. There was almost nothing in it, but hopefully that will be okay. And then I'm going to fill it up, and next step is to put the battery in, momentarily at least, to check if we get oil pressure on this engine. So I will fill up the last oil, put in the battery, and then we'll try to crank. There we go. We have oil on the engine. I have rigged up the wiring for the oil pressure sender and made sure that no live wire is touching anything. So now we're just gonna crank the engine, and so we should have a light on the dash right there. When that goes out, we have oil pressure. Let's hope. It is not weird that it's taking its some time, because the oil filter is completely empty and the pump is not filled either. So it will come soon. Yep. It took some time, but it came. Okay, we are getting ready to the first firing up test, startup test of this engine. I'm just going to change the fuel filter because I can't even see through it. But one thing I can see is the arrow. Where did I see that? Saw that just before. It's right here. This filter is on backwards. So, yeah. And I put on the known good box of contacts. And I put the carb on. And strip somewhere to avoid this one from falling down. So that one has fallen off. Where is that? That one. Where is it? Here it is. So, fuel on, pipe on. Yeah. It should be able to start right now. But it would be noisy because there's no muffler on it. It's just to see if it even want to start. And as I told you in the previous video, remember to remove the drill, or else it will just break. I got lucky there. Now let's see if it wanna do something. and runs, and sounded quite good actually for the first startup at least. I'm going to put the exhaust on and the fan on and pretty much everything I think, and then I'm going to start it up again. So this has been quite a long day and I'm about to say that I'm finished actually. Everything is back on and I have not tested if everything works yet, but I will do that with you. The exhaust gave me a lot of troubles fitting it, but now it's good. It is still not tight though, and that is not because of the work that I have done up here, but because that this rear box is cracked, so it's a bit noisy still. Also the starter motor is about to be worn out, but we already knew that. But the engine is in and it sounds pretty good, I think. Let's try to see if we can start it. Yeah, that's what the starter engine does. It really needs a new starter. I also think low power is part of this right now. Yeah, I should have sat in the car. So there we have it. I have now finished up everything, put the car on the ground again, and now we're going to take it for a little ride to see if the engine is pulling as it should, and you will most likely fall down, but let's see. Yeah, I haven't filmed a lot of the process in putting the engine back in, but it's pretty much the same as when I removed the other one, just the other way around. And there has been a lot of fiddly things today, and it has been taking quite a while actually. But the good part is so far so good. The engine is sounding very, very good. When we take it for a ride, you will notice that it's quite noisy, and that's because the back box of this exhaust system is broken. Nothing we can do about that right now. And the starter engine is quite bad as well. But oh no! You fell down. that's all for the Dyane videos for this time at least. Now it's fixed and ready to go. It needs the new starter though, and it needs a new rear silencer. So if you like what you see, please hit the subscribe button, and there will be a lot of future project on this channel. The next project is to clean up. I'm not gonna make a video about that, but then the next project will be the wonderful lawnmower right there, and then we'll get back to the Renault 5 GT Turbo again. We got the engine parts today, so that's really nice. Yeah, see you later.